Welcome to video 34 on flight sim navigation. We've been working on this radio and autopilot panel with the MobiFlight software, and so far we configured all the encoders that we need, and also we configured these displays over here. So all that's left now to configure is the push buttons that switch several functions of the autopilot on or off with their accompanying LEDs. Those are built in these switches, and the LEDs are not working just on their own via the Arduino. No, they are really controlled by the flight sim software, so only if the function is switched on, this LED is on. Let's have a look how to configure these. As always, we first have to tell the Arduino that we have certain hardware connected, in this case buttons and LEDs. To do that, go to the extra menu, settings, and then the MobiFlight modules tab. There we click the module that we have, and then this button add device becomes active. So we can add a button and we can add an LED. Well, in this case we are going to add multiple buttons and multiple LEDs. I already did it, so let's for example find our heading button. Over here it is. Then what you need to do is select the pin number where that button is connected to. And the other side of the button is connected to ground. So the button is either floating, which means it is connected to 5 volt via the internal Arduino input resistor, or it is connected to ground when you push the button. We give it a name. Well, I just kept it simple, button heading, and that's it. Then of course we do the same for the LEDs. So we have we add a device, and in that case we add here an LED / output, and I already added them, and there we have the same things we need to do here. Select a pin number and give it a name. That's it. When you are done with all your buttons and all your LEDs, don't forget to upload the current configuration to the Arduino, and it is always a good practice to also save your file for maybe later use. Well, that's it. Now we need to configure the inputs, and for that of course we go here to the input tab, and there we add our buttons. We scroll down the list to double click here on this row to add a configuration. I already did it, so when you do that you give it a name, then activate it by this tick over here, and then in the edit button, that's where we configure it really. It is our Mega Arduino Mega module that we need to select, and then from the drop down list we select the button that we just configured in the hardware. So this is the name, button heading. And then what is the event ID? Well, for the autopilot heading, that is autopilot heading hold. So from this very long list, just select, find and select the function that you want this push button to do. In this case, autopilot heading hold. Don't forget to press use, because only then these numbers are filled in and we are done. That is it for the push button, but of course we also want to LED inside that push button to burn when the autopilot heading is active. And that is what we do here in the output tab. Again, we scroll down to the list, down the list, and double click this row to add a new config. Give it a name, activate it, and here in the edit button we need to do two things. In the FSUIPC tab we select the preset that we need, in this case autopilot heading hold. That is the LED, the bit that is either 0 or 1 that lights up our LED. If we press use, then the numbers over here are filled in and we do not have to do anything else. Well, we could take away this more options tick mark with the transform because we don't need a transform. And then another thing to do, this is an LED, an output, so we have to tell which of the LEDs we want to light up. So we go to the display tab, we again select our Arduino Mega, then we select as a type a pin, and then from the list we select, well, in this case, LED heading. That's the one I want to light up when this button is pressed. We can, of course, already test it right now, and we should see the LED light up. This is it. This is what we need to do, and we can do this for every of the buttons and LEDs. The list of all the events and the FSUI PC data is in the link that is under this video. So I wish you success, and with me it all worked fine, except for, I think, VNAV. I was not able to find yet how to do that, but maybe we can clear that up later. I think in the next video we will simply make a flight using our new fully configured autopilot module. See you back there.